Peace and love, this is Yari, and this video is about the Venus and Aquarius transit. So, Venus is now in Aquarius, it just came out of Capricorn. Capricorn is telling us to nail things down, take things serious, go the speed limit, and also to invest. And so, it was telling us to commit to what we were doing before we spent our time, our money, our energy on anything. And it was also making sure that we were dedicated and we were doing the work and also being productive before we enjoyed ourselves. And so, Venus, I would say our relationships, connections, or however, was going around a mountain. Okay, and anybody who made it around this mountain was supposed to be here. Now that Venus is in Aquarius, so wherever there wasn't commitment, wherever people weren't keeping their word, or there was lack of integrity, whether it was on your end or on other people's end, and wherever you weren't corresponding properly to wherever you having obstacles in your life, this is why the Venus in Aquarius may not have been comfortable. For some people, I'm sorry, the Venus in Capricorn may not have been comfortable for some people, because now that it's in Aquarius, these are the chances that we can take with our power when we're aligned, or these are things that can bring the chaos or drama when we're not aligned. And so the integrity that we learn, the structure that we learn, following the rules and doing what we were supposed to do when Venus was in Capricorn set off everything that takes place now with Venus being in Aquarius. Venus in Aquarius now, especially when it comes to love, there are a lot of different options here now. And so wherever there isn't loyalty or honor in your relationships at work or however, this is why I call it the hiring and the firing. This is the breakups and the makeups of it all. These are the unexpected chances and the unexpected changes. Okay, so this is miracles and disasters, things that are going to go very right and very wrong for some people. So like I say, it goes back to the faith, the loyalty, and the honor in what you're doing and what you've been attracting into your life. Whatever you didn't clear out or whatever you weren't in receive mode in with that full moon in Leo is going to bring a whole lot of light to what you need to work on with this Venus in Aquarius. So this is why I say a lot of people may be uncomfortable, okay? Every sign teaches us something as the planet transits through them. And so when we behave and we take on the energy of the sign, the law, the universal law that's attracted to it and that it's connected to, and all of the work that we're supposed to do with that chakra will move you forward. So that's why with our bodies, there are things we need to do. And this is talking about the circulatory system and how we're moving things around. We're flirting with life, okay? And so in order for us to really have things going on with our heart and really be pumping that blood properly and be excited, we have what? We have to have proper circulation, and we need our heart to be pumping for everything to get around to our bodies for us to get everything that we need, right? So as we're all one body, we need to gather our pleasure through Aquarius and moving around. So when we're talking about the energy, this is talking about the law of cause and effect. Things that could go right, and like I say, things that can go wrong, but the source of it all. The source of it all is the most important. So you want to pay attention to this, okay? Be aware of yourself and be aware of your connections, because there's always something that can happen, not just because of your doing or your dealing. It's your dealings and your connections to other people, why you can sometimes get the result of somebody else's karma, or you know how something can splash or spill on somebody else and some of it still gets on you, the residue, all is well. And so these things take place when we don't listen to ourselves and have discernment in our dealings with other people. This is still energy, you guys, and everybody is walking different paths. And so Venus in Aquarius is telling us to move around, but it's still telling us to be cautious. All right, use our wisdom, pay attention, you know, be aware of everything so that you don't miss out on anything as far as opportunities, but you don't miss out on anything wherever there was a threat and something could be where you need to be defending yourself and watching out for those things. You want to watch out for your gifts and abilities. We want to share them. We want to have the glory of them, but we also want to preserve them. We want to protect them, because this is also talking about where there could be copycats. Okay. You want to influence people, but you also want to preserve what is yours. You want to protect what is yours. Because what is yours is for you. So nobody else can do what you do, how you do. But we don't have to give up every little thing about ourselves when we want to influence people and we want to connect to people. Some of us, we have to save just for us, even our relationship with the divine, which is quite okay. All right. And so you want to think about that. With Venus in Aquarius, people might be open to different things when it's talking about options once again with love. Okay. So this is talking about the polyamorous relationships, the polygamy, all of those things where people are opening up to different options or what's typically unconventional, because Aquarius is an unconventional sign. And so they don't go, you know, and do what everybody else is doing. They stand out and they go against the grain. And they're just, like I say, open. And so this is also talking about tolerance of it all. So even if we don't agree with different things and different lifestyles and different cultures, there's always a place to learn, because it always helps you and it helps to elevate with your intellect. So the tolerance of it all will help you to take shape and change shapes when you're around different people, when you're doing different things. And when, like I say, taking a chance and doing something you've never done is also learning yourself. And so that Venus in Aquarius helps you to learn yourself. It's a whole nother degree and a whole nother time frame for you to grasp the reins and wake up to that part of you that might be open, but you didn't know how to go about it. So this is why meeting the new people and being a part of different groups and being in, I would say, organizations and clubs and just joining things like that, that appeal to you with different topics and things you've never thought about or things you may have very much thought about, but like I say, you may have been scared or however. This is a time to change your size. This is a time to change your mind. This is a time to change your perception. Be invent something, you know, take that time, because like I say, the other planets are there. Saturn is here. Jupiter is still here. The sun is here. Look at all these major planets that are giving you so much of a boost. And so you don't want to forget about the things you did during this time, because this is kicking off for the rest of the year. The things you get, the things you do, and the things and the people that you attract to yourself, the opportunities that you get, all that bliss and fortune that is promised to you. You want to make sure that you are going by the script and you are doing the right thing and you're on. And that's why this is not a time for shyness. This is a time to break out of that shyness. Wherever you're shy, because all of us are open and extroverted in different areas, but all of us are also introverted and might be a little shy in different areas. I would say break out of your comfort zone. Wherever you wouldn't normally do something, this is a time to try and just test your foot in the waters, just to see if you like it, just to see how you feel and get that adrenaline rush about what you've never done. So it's a lot of energy at our solar plexus, at our crown chakra, at our third eye chakra. Connecting to people in these areas that are part of our purpose is so amazing. And so that's why I say people you never thought you would talk to, you know, people you never thought you would even like share the same ideals with, they're there. They're there. So all of us are unicorns in different ways. This is a time to find your crew, you know, find other people who move like you. This is a time to move things around when it comes to your jobs, your opportunities, where you work at, your career, adding changes to what you're already doing with your business, in your relationships. That's why I say a lot of people might be open to open relationships or adding a partner, threesomes, the whole deal with Venus being in Aquarius. If this is a natal transit, this is a time, this is your Venus return. So this is a time for you to evaluate your love and your money and measure yourself from the past few years and where you are now and where you want to be in the future. All right. All is well, you guys. I hope you enjoy this transit. Reach out to me for your own personal session.